recently, I felt in my heart the best thing to do is to drop my comedy special to my fans for free. So now what needs to happen is I have to write some more content. I'm gonna show you how I write jokes. Really, I'm just showing my work. You're probably not gonna laugh out loud watching this video. This is the process. Hi, yo, welcome. I'm super excited. You're probably not ready for this, right? You probably haven't seen the Dark Kents before. So in case you've never seen this video before, or I should say never seen me on video before, my name is Michael Jr. I started my career doing stand-up comedy. Now some have referred to me as a comedic thought leader. Here's what I'm about to do. I'm going to show you my comedy writing process. Anyway, you're probably not gonna laugh out loud watching this video. I'm just gonna, like, if that's what you wanna do, you should go check out the comedy special. All that stuff has been worked, it's been polished. That's not what this is. This is the process. Step one. You have to come up with what is called a premise. A premise is an idea of something that you think is funny. Things that are funny when I see them or when everybody else sees them, I never put that stuff on stage. I have friends and people that I meet all the time, and they may do something that they think is funny or something just happened, like they spilt their drink on their lap and they're like, ha, 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 that's gonna end up in your comedy show, isn't it? No, it's not. It's really kind of boring, actually. You're not gonna see me on stage saying, yo, I was hanging out with a friend the other day and he spilt his water in his lap. Nah, bro, that's not what's gonna happen. What's probably happening at that point is I'm probably looking at another table to see how they responded to this water dropping in his lap, and then something will come from there, and I'll probably never even mention the water. So I'm just giving you a feel for how I think with regards to comedy. So you have to come up with a premise. So I have a premise that I started. So my process with regards to coming up with premises is I'll just do life, and comedy just kind of shows up. I really believe when you're walking in or towards your purpose, God will open up doors that you can walk through, and more importantly, some other doors won't open. So for me, comedy literally follows me. So what I'll do is I'll take my phone. I got a phone. Some people say it's smart. I don't know. We never really had a conversation before. But I'll take my phone, and I have this little thing set up where all I do is push one button, and boom, this email will pop up, and I can speak into it or whatever, and it goes to this program where I then have a list of all of my thoughts and ideas that have spontaneously came up, right? So once I have that list, whenever it's time to sit down like I'm doing right now, I'll just pull up that list and see what I feel like working on, and then I kind of jump into that thing. Now, in the past, when I was only a comedian, I would just find out whatever's funny, and I would just do that joke. But now that I'm more concerned with really helping people get in a better place, because people show up to my comedy shows because they want to laugh, but that might not be all they need. They may need something a little more, and I want to be in a place where I can give that to them. So after I have a list of premise, I just go through and get a feel for what I should work on. So today's premise, I had a thought to become a vegetarian. It's just a thought. Okay, calm down. I know I live in Texas. Some of my boys is like, you doing what? No. Had the thought. Like, what is the pros and cons of vegetarianism and meatism? So I start asking friends, and whoa, you got some opinionated people kind of on both sides. So that's really the premise. That's the thing that I want to massage and get a feel for a little bit. So now what I need to do is I got to kind of walk that thought process through. Some of the thoughts that come to my mind is, well, that's really about eating healthy or not, or if it's healthy or not. So I would just think that process through. So now I got to think about, what is my position on vegetarianism? Actually, it's a hilarious word. You see what just happened? So sometimes my process, or actually all the time, my process is to externally process. Even if I'm in a room by myself, I have to sometimes say this stuff like out loud in a way where I can hear it. It bounce off the wall and come back to me, then I can tweak it a little bit. So vegetarianism is a really cool word. And it could be a bad thing if I wanted to. It could be like a syndrome, depending on what side of the fence I land on with regards to not eating meat. I had a thought of not being a vegetarian, but being like a second generation vegetarian, right? Because a second generation vegetarian, that means I only eat animals that were vegetarian. So there's something, boom, there's a little something right there. So, and then I'll think about the word vegetarian. Like, I'll break the word down. Vegetarian. Sound like it could be a church denomination, really. Like, you got those Presbyterians, you got the Otherians, and then you got the vegetarians. Yeah, again, I want you to know, none of this is probably gonna be funny right now, but when you see it on stage, whoa, it might be funny. Gotta be real with you, I don't know for sure. So then I'll give you a couple more examples of what I was thinking. One of the things right now is I like to, a lot of people are like gluten-free, and I am, I like free things, but I also like gluten. So technically right now, I'm like vegan-free. That's what I'm throwing out there right now. I'm a vegan-free individual. There's other phrases that kind of come to mind in regards to this, like, oh, there's an impossible burger out right now. Like, it's impossible. My thought process was, it's probably impossible for it to taste delicious, too. Because it doesn't have meat in it. That's what they say. It ain't no meat. It just tastes like a burger, but it ain't. But there's no meat in it. And I'm like, really? Because I've heard of that before. I think it's called Burger King. I gotta work that out a little bit. So now what I have to do is I gotta continue to just talk those things through. Maybe go get into a mirror or whatnot and just talk them through. I told you it wasn't gonna be glorious and all amazing and things just flying right. Oh, it was so much. He's so funny. No, this stuff is some work. It probably takes about, I don't know, if I wanted to write an hour of comedy, it would probably take a good year because I gotta polish it out. I could probably get it done in 6 months if I'm really hitting the stage a lot. But I got a family. I love them. They're amazing. So it's a little longer for me. In the next video, the next step basically is me doing the thing I refer to as calling an associated person. Yeah, so we just went through the premise. And now you'll find out what I mean by call an associated person. It's a really cool process. You'll see it in the next video. Meanwhile, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you learned a little bit. Really, I'm just showing my work. Like, this is the work that happens before I hit the stage. And I'm glad you chose to be a part of it.